Ages. My name is Michael, and welcome to Pizza Mon Mario. Welcome to my third video game collection video of 2019. My last video I did was my game collection video, and then I also did my N64 game collection. So if you want to see those collections first before you watch this video, it's going to be my Wii collection, then I'll have those videos linked in the description, so you can go check them out. So until you decide to watch this video, if you're going to be doing that, then I will see you whenever you watch this video. So peace out to you guys. Alright, as for the rest of you sticking around, allow me to tell you guys my experience with the Wii. Also, if you hear anything in the background, that's my fan over there. Because where I am is like 95 degrees, so yeah. But anyway, so my experience with the Wii is my very first console that I ever owned. I still remember the days when I like begged my mom to have it. Like, I literally begged, literally on my hands and knees begging for that thing. It came out at the time when Mario Party 8 came out. I don't remember the exact date, but I remember when Mario Party 8 first introduced me to the Wii. Since then, I like begged my mom for it, and when I finally got it on that Christmas, I was so incredibly happy to finally have my hands on it. So yeah. Here's my Wii. It's a little dirty, but that's because I've had it for a long period of time. And there's my Switch down there as well. And yeah, I also play my GameCube games on here because, like I mentioned in my GameCube collection video, my GameCube does not work anymore. So I just play my GameCube games on the Wii. I haven't played any of my Wii games on the Wii U. I haven't tried that out, but I don't play them. Plan on ever trying it out. And speaking of games, here is all of my Wii games. And a pig. Yeah. So this is currently the biggest collection of games that I have. I have 46 games. And I'm going to go ahead and show them off to you. So y'all take a seat, get comfortable, grab your snacks and your beverages, and let's get started. Starting off with the first stack, we have Wii Sports, of course. Gotta start off with Wii Sports. I mean, why would I start with anything else other than Wii Sports? Pretty much sure that this came with everybody's Wii. At least I think it came in every Wii. Or it could have been like crossbow training as well. But yeah, I don't think I really need to say anything about Wii Sports. I mean, it's just your a bunch of sports, you play with your Miis. And it's always fun to throw on every once in a while. If you're bored, you just want to play have some fun, just play something casually. So yeah, really don't need to say anything about Wii Sports. Alright, next we have Cartoon Network Punch Time Explosion XL. What can I really say about this game other than the fact that it's Smash Bros. Brawl with Cartoon Network characters inside of it? This game does get a lot of hate though, but I don't understand why, because I think this is a very, very fun game. I mean, if a game plays like Smash Bros., I think it's good. So yeah, I really don't see what the hate for this game is. I mean, sure, it doesn't have like some like popular characters like Courage Cowardly Dog or Edna and Eddie, but I really think this is a phenomenal game, despite the scores. Alright, next is The Croods Prehistoric Party. The reason why I got this was because it was when I saw the commercial for it, it was like a Mario Party game, so I thought I would like it. In the game, well, first of all, I'm gonna talk about the movie, because I saw the movie like a few years later. I thought the movie was kind of just meh. And the same thing with the game, it's kind of meh. I mean, it's not bad by any means, but it's, I mean, there are a lot of really fun minigames in here. Overall, I feel like you can go worse. I feel like there are worse party games out there than the Creepy Creep Dark Party. Alright, next we have The Blob. Now in this game, you play as Blob, which is this character right here. And you have to save Chroma City from the evil Ink Corporation. From Houston, because you're doing all the color. Kind of like Pokemon Color Splash. Yeah, definitely recommend it. It's a pretty fun game. I haven't beaten it yet. Also, did I show the inside of the Cruise? I don't know if I did. It's a very fun game. It is also on the Switch now, as well as the sequel. Never played a sequel. We have Donkey Kong Country Returns. Another very, very fun game. Never played any other Donkey Kong Country game other than this, other than Tropical Freeze. But this is still a very fun game. Definitely check this game out if you want to have it for your Wii. So I'm still looking for the 3DS version as well. And next we have Family Feud Decades. My family's favorite game show of all time, so if you like Family Feud, you will like this game. Not one much to say about it, it's just Family Feud. Yeah. Next is Fortune Street, which is Mario and Dragon Quest version of Monopoly. That's pretty much what it is. It's Monopoly. So if you play Monopoly, you understand what this game is like. Yeah, it's fun for game nights, definitely. I can see them actually porting this game to the Switch. I mean, unless I'd rather have a new game. But I feel like I can see this game actually getting ported to the Switch. Yeah, if you like Monopoly or party games in general, you'll like this game. It's a good game. Next is Kirby's Return to Dream Land. Another really good game. I don't think this game needs any introductions. Very fun co-op game. Although I haven't played co-op with anybody. But great Kirby game. I don't think I really need to say much about that, as it's been said already. Next we have Madagascar Karts, which is a Mario Kart ripoff, pretty much, of Madagascar. The only reason why I got this is because I'm a big fan of Madagascar. It's my favorite, one of my favorite anime movies of all time. Maybe we should do a top 5 anime movies video. Yeah. So this game is, I mean, it's fun for a little while. And you get to play as so many of the Madagascar characters. You get to play as Alex, Marty, Melman, Gloria. Julian's in here. You play the penguins, the chimps. And for some reason, Shrek and Bob from Monsters Aliens is in here. I guess they ran out of characters, but I mean, it's an okay game. I mean, I feel like, once again, like kind of like with the Croods, I feel like you can go worse. And then now we have Mario and Sonic at the London 2012 Olympic Games, Mario and Sonic the Olympic Games, and Mario and Sonic the Olympic Winter Games. All three of the Mario and Sonic Olympic Games games. I mean, everyone wishes that they're platformers, but I still think that these games are really, really fun. I know I completed London 2012 and the Olympic Winter Games, but I haven't completed all the Olympic Games yet. It's currently in my Wii right now, because this is in my backlog of games to be over summer. I actually forget, God, it was in my Wii. Can't wait for Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games to come out. I'm really looking forward to that game. I'm probably one of, like, one of the few people on the planet who's looking forward to that game, but yeah. Next is, of course, Mario Kart Wii. This game definitely needs no introduction. I mean, what do I need to say about Mario Kart Wii? It's Mario Kart. I don't need to say anything about this. Amazing game. Definitely in my top 5 favorite Mario Kart games. And then here's the game that made me want a Wii so badly, and the first game I got on my Wii, Mario Party 8. And then, of course, we also have Mario Party 9, which, I'm going to say this right now, this is a good game, guys. Mario Party 9 is a good game. I know so much of the fan base criticizes the car mechanic. Personally, all right, let me just explain myself. I think the car gimmick is actually a very unique gimmick. At least for story mode, it's fine, but I think for a gimmick, it's actually very interesting, because it makes you feel like you're on an adventure. I mean, it makes the boards a lot more strategic. I mean, that's just my personal opinion. I mean, I only play Mario Party for the minigames anyway, because I only really care about the minigames. That's really all it is with me and Mario Party. We have Mario Sports Mix. Great game. Great Mario Sports game. I really want another one of these games on the Switch. So, Square Enix, if you can get together with Nintendo, can we get another Mario Sports game like this? Not a port, but a new game. This was a very fun game. Definitely probably my top 5 favorite Wii games. We have Mario Strikers Charge. This is a printed out label because I got this game loose at GameStop. And I mentioned in my GameCube collection video that kind of like the GameCube versions of Strikers Charged and Super Sluggers. Like, let me get Super Sluggers. So Super Sluggers. This is also a loose copy again at GameStop, so it's a printed out label. But I kind of like these versions better than the GameCube versions, because I just feel like they're a lot easier to play. I mean, not easier to play, but like for Sluggers Charge, it's easier to actually get hits and home runs. And Sluggers Charge, it's easier to actually score goals. That's just my personal opinion. Here we have Mortal Kombat Armageddon. One of two M-rated video games you will find in my video game collection, because normally I don't play M-rated games. Yeah, it's Mortal Kombat. Probably not the same thing about it. It has a huge cast of characters. And if you want to know who my favorite character in Mortal Kombat is, it's probably Baraka, because he's like the first person I ever used. Yeah, I don't think I really see much about Mortal Kombat again. I haven't beaten the story mode, but whatever. And there's also a Mortal Kombat mode, which is like a Mario Kart version of this. It's a more brutal. Yeah, that's cool. Now here's my most recent acquisition to my GameCube collection. New Play Control Mario Power Tennis. I got this game at my local used game store, Game Exchange. Along with Super Mario Bros. 2 on the NES. Now, people complain about the controls in this game, which I can understand. But for me, like, as long as like, I got used to controls, and so it's not that difficult for me. I mean, using the auto controls, so I mean, I guess it's kind of makes me look like a wimp, but I think when, if you can get used to controls, I can't speak, then it might not be that hard. Next is New Super Mario Bros. Wii. Another Wii game that absolutely needs no introduction. Great game. I mean, I don't think I really need to say about Mario Bros. Wii. Definitely a must-have for Wii owners out there. You know, you have Nicktoons Attack of Toy Bots, which is a game I got on my birthday. And I haven't beaten it yet. I got stuck on the Amity Park level. But I hope to get back into this soon. A lot of the Ultimate Team's Night games are really fun. A lot of people say this is their favorite game, but this is not my personal favorite. You'll see my favorite one later on, because also I got that on the Wii. And the last game in the first deck is Nicktoons MLB. Now this is like, if you ever heard the movie Space Jam, this is pretty much like you have a bunch of Nicktoons characters, and you play baseball with real life players. You got characters from SpongeBob, Avatar, Ren Stimpy, Invader Zim is in the game, which is probably like why most people would buy this game, because Invader Zim, because everybody seems to love Invader Zim. Yeah. Once again, I feel like there's a lot worse baseball games out there, because this is actually a very fun game. I actually do enjoy playing this every once in a while. So yeah, I mean, it's not the best baseball game in the world, but I personally think it's a good game. Alright, moving on to my second stack, we have Pac-Man Party. Obviously, you can tell from the title, this is a Pac-Man Party game. So in the party mode of this game, what you do is you get castles and you end up battling for them with mini games. It kind of looks similar to Monopoly. Like, I don't really know much about it because I haven't played that much of the party mode. Like, once again, just play the mini game mode. And there are some really fun mini games in here. So if you like Mario Party or if you like Pac-Man, you'll like this game. Now you move on to a bunch of Pokemon games. We have Pokemon Battle Revolution. It's like a Pokemon game, but I haven't played too much of it because I'm stuck on the Neon Colosseum, which if you guys have played this game, you know about Neon Colosseum. That is just a brutal Colosseum. Awesome music, but it's really hard because you have to get select your Pokemon via wheel, and you never want to get your opponent's Pokemon because they can't fight. Like, they don't know any like good moves. So when you get them, you're just like, oh no. And then when they get your best Pokemon, you're like, ah, come on. So yeah, I just can't get past that Colosseum to save my life. But if you like Pokemon games, you'll like this game. It is a good game, though. And then here we have PokePark Wii, Pikachu's Adventure, and PokePark 2, Wonders Beyond. These are really great games. I definitely have a lot of nostalgic memories playing these games. They're just cute and harmless. You go around, and you befriend Pokemon, you can battle them, play hide-and-seek with them, play tag with them. It's just cute and harmless. So it's a nice chill game. And then in the second game, you can play as Oshawott, Snivy, and Tepig as well when you unlock them. I also heard this game's actually pretty expensive. Let me know in the comments if that's true, because I heard this actually is a pretty expensive game. Yeah, definitely pick those games up if you like Pokemon. If you like really cute and calm, chill games. Alright, next up we have Rayman Raving Rabbids and Rayman Raving Rabbids 2. Two other recent additions to my GameCube, my Wii collection, and they're all both fun party games. I could have got these games a long time ago. Like, I remember when I was taking, like, I'm surprised I didn't have these games a long time ago, because I got Rayman Legends in like April, and then Rayman Raving Rabbids 2 I got for my birthday. I mean, I could have got these a long time ago, but I didn't become a fan of the Rabbids until I watched Rabbids Invasion cartoon, which is a very funny cartoon. I really did like Rayman. I mean, not Rayman. Rabbids Invasion. They were two great games. Definitely pick those games up if you like party games. And then we have a couple Sonic games. Well, I guess this one is technically a Sonic game, but Sonic's in it. Sega Superstars Tennis, which is Sega's version of Mario Tennis. Very fun game. and this copy comes from JFC, because I got this through GameStop. So whoever JFC is, I have your game, so hope you don't mind. And then here we have Sonic and the Black Knight. This game does get a lot of hate, but I think it's okay. I think it's okay Sonic game. Part of Sonic Storybook Series. Still looking for Sonic in the Secret Reigns, so I can have both the Sonic. I don't remember where I left off in this game. I know I got stuck on one level, but I think it's a good Sonic game. And then here we have Sonic Colors, which also is a very good Sonic game. It definitely plays a lot of like the ones on the Genesis. So definitely, if you're a fan of like the Genesis Sonic games, definitely check out Sonic Colors. I haven't beaten that game either. I don't remember where I left off. Now here's the other one of the Nicktoons United games, and my favorite one out of the four of them, is SpongeBob SquarePants featuring Nicktoons Globs of Doom. Now, I really don't get the hate for this game. This game does get a lot of hate. People say like it killed the series, but I just don't get why. Like, I think this is a very fun game. And a really great soundtrack, too. I think this has the best soundtrack of all of them, in my opinion. And plus, you can play as Invader Zim. Invader Zim is playable in here. And Dib. I mean, how would you not want to play Invader Zim and Dib? I mean, that's probably, once again, the reason why anyone would want this game. But I personally love this game. Great game, great soundtrack. I just don't get the hate. I mean, SpongeBob and Invader Zim together in the game, you can even play them in one level? Like, how can you say no to that? I mean, I'm also really excited for the Invader Zim movie when that comes out. Hope it's good. Next, you got Super Mario All-Stars. This is made for the 25th anniversary of Mario. And it's also available on Super Nintendo. Which I don't have a Super Nintendo, but I don't think I'm going to say much about it. It's just enhanced graphics of Super Mario Bros. 1, 2, and 3. And Super Mario Bros. 2 of the Lost Levels, which is not released in North America because us Americans were very weak, so we couldn't play that. And now we have Super Mario Galaxy and Super Mario Galaxy 2. Like I mentioned in my top 5 Mario games video, I love these games. I don't know which one I like better, but amazing, amazing games. Beautiful games, beautiful music. If you're someone out there who hates these Mario Galaxy games, you clearly have no taste in games. These are amazing, amazing games. And if a third one came out on the Switch, I'd be so happy. Which is probably never going to happen, but we can all dream. But I really don't think I need to say anything about Mario Galaxy 1 and 2. They're, like, definitely must-haves for any Wii owner. Alright, here we have Super Paper Mario. There's another printed out label. Now, this game is nowadays the game kind of respected it deserves, because it is a good game. I haven't beaten it yet, but it is a good game. I mean, I know people still despise Sticker Star and Color Splash, but Super Paper Mario kind of get somewhat of respect that it deserves. But, I mean, people probably still trash on it, but it's a really great game, though. Yeah, Super Smash Bros. Brawl. I still remember when I begged my mom for this game, too, when I first saw it. And then I saw it in my Wii collection one day, I was like, wow, she actually got it for me. Great game. I mean, a lot of people complain about this game a little bit. They say it's the worst one of the Smash Bros. Games. This is probably my second favorite of the series. It's because this is my introduction to Smash Bros. So I really think this is a really great game. So I don't see why like people will trash on it. Next is another printed out label game. It's the worst one I have. Tatsunoko vs. Capcom Ultimate All-Stars. I mean, look at that cover. I really have to redo this cover at some point. Yeah, another one with like Marvel vs. Capcom like games with Tatsunoko, which I think is like an anime company. And my two mains in here I do is Mega Man Volnot and Beautiful Joe. If you like those Marvel vs. Capcom games, you will like that game. Now we have Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Smash Up, which is a Smash Brothers-like game with the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles characters. Apparently this game came out of the comic book, but this is the point that label, so I don't have the comic book. But if you like Ninja Turtles and if you like Smash Bros., I think you'll definitely like this game. There are a lot of unique things in this game that's not in Smash Bros., like a wall jump move. Like, you can jump off of walls and just go like, boom, jump! Just kick someone. It's really cool. Also, if you get the Wii version, you can play as 3 Rabbids. I guess the game is made by Ubisoft. It's a Wii exclusive. So, yeah. That's cool. Next is Virtua Tennis 4. Which, I only wanted this because I want to see what it was like. Because I got Sega Superstars Tennis and I wanted to see what this game was like. It's just here a generic tennis game. But you can create your own player and go through the world tour mode and play against people from all over the world. And there's a couple of mini games in here, so I guess if you just like tennis, you can check it out. Because not really much to say about it, it's just a generic tennis game. Then we have Wario Land Shake It. Very fun 2D platformer. I think we need another Wario Land. We should get another Wario Land game on the Switch. And not a port of this. We should get another Wario Land game. This is a very great game. Wario Land Shake It. I think this game needs no introduction. Next you have Wii Party. We're coming down to the end of my collection here. So Wii Party is Mario Party with your mini games. I mean with your Miis. I guess those mini games. Yeah. It's an okay game to play. Kinda like with Wii Sports, it's okay to play. It's just wanna play something casual. Then it's okay to just throw on for like an hour. It's a great game. And then here we have WWE 12 and WWE 13. Yes, I'm pretty sure these Wii versions are not as good as the Xbox 360 and PS3 versions, but I don't have those consoles, so I'm stuck with these versions. Which is fine, I don't mind. I mean, graphically they're not great, but graphics don't matter in the game. At least not to me. I remember I played WWE 13 like crazy, playing the Universe mode. Love the Universe mode. Yeah, they're great games either way. Whether if you like old school wrestling games, definitely check these games out, but probably stick with the PS3 or Xbox 360 versions if you want like better experience, I suppose. And then the last Wii game that I have is Zack and Ricky, Quest for Barbarossa's Treasure. A point-and-click puzzle adventure game. I don't remember where I left off in here. I know I have not beaten it. But it's a pretty interesting game. And you play as this pirate, Zack, and his pet monkey, golden monkey, Ricky. And you have to solve puzzles and retrieve the bones of Barbarossa. It's pretty interesting. It's also a Capcom title, so there's some quality in here. So definitely check this game out if you have a Wii.
Alright, so that is my entire Wii game collection. Pretty okay stack, I would say. I mean, I know I don't have, like, Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword or Twilight Princess or Metroid Prime and Corruption, but I still think it's an okay stack. I know some other games I want to get in the future, like, for Mario games, because if you guys saw my Mario game collection video, I'm trying to go for complete North American release Mario game set for every Nintendo system. And for those games I'm missing, Donkey Kong Barrel Blast, New Play Control, Donkey Kong Jungle Beat, WarioWare Smooth Moves, and Skylanders Superchargers Racing, which is not a Mario game, but Bowser is playable, so I consider that to be part of the collection. Just because there's a playable guest star of a Mario character in there. And then there's also stuff I want to get, like Sonic and Secret Reigns, Sonic Unleashed, which, I mean, I know those games aren't like very popular with the fan base, but I want to try them out anyway. And I want to try out Kirby's Epic Yarn. I mean, I know it's on the Wii, but I mean, on the 3DS, but I want to get the Wii version. And then there's stuff like Epic Mickey, Punch-Out, and a few other games. So, yeah.
With all that being said, that is the end of my Wii game collection video. Did you like it? If you did, be sure to punch that like button below, like a piece of dough. And if this is your first time on this channel, hit that subscribe button so that you can become a member of the Pizza Mon Mario Party today. Be sure to share this video with your friends, your boyfriends or your girlfriends, or whoever you want to share with, and turn on the notifications so you can be the first one to see all upcoming videos. And if you have time, leave a comment. And then my next collection video I'm going to be doing is going to be my Wii U collection. So until then, hope you all have a great rest of your day. Until next time, this is Mike signing off. So, peace out, y'all.
This is now currently my longest video I have on my channel.